He was handsome, cultured, athletic, and fun-loving. Declared blessed by the Catholic Church in 1990, Pier Giorgio Frassati was a vibrant young man who smoked a pipe, loved the outdoors, especially skiing and mountain climbing, and enjoyed clowning around with his friends, who ironically called themselves the Sinister Ones. Born in 1901 in Turin, Italy, his father was a journalist who at one time was the Italian ambassador to Germany, and his mother was an artist, a painter. They were quite well off, and neither one of his parents was very religious. While a good athlete, academics were not Pier Giorgio's forte. He struggled in school, and his parents eventually sent him to a Jesuit academy. There he received the academic support he needed to succeed. He would not only graduate, but eventually be admitted to the university. At school, he loved to joke around, often pulling pranks, short-sheeting a priest's bed, or signing homework with phony names. He enjoyed theater, museums, concerts, and was quite well-read. He especially loved Dante. He also loved to discuss and debate with his friends in the cafes or while hiking, especially those forbidden topics, politics and religion. But there was a side to Pier Giorgio not everyone knew about. He had a rich spiritual life. He prayed 3 times a day and attended Mass and received the Eucharist every morning. And Pier Giorgio put his faith into action. He joined the St. Vincent de Paul Society and did all kinds of good works that he kept hidden, good works which became public only after his death. His family told the story of a time when, as a boy, he answered the door to find a poor child and mother begging. When he saw the child had no shoes, Pierre immediately took off his own shoes and gave them to the boy. His parents gave him the train fare he needed to get back and forth to school each day. Instead of riding first class, Pier Giorgio would buy a third class ticket, take the money he was saving, and give it to those in need. Sometimes he ran home and gave the entire train fare away. On an unusually cold night in Turin, he literally took the coat off his back to give to a beggar. His father wasn't too happy about it. Pier Giorgio replied simply, "But Dad, it was cold." When he graduated from school, his father gave him a choice, a car or cash. He chose the cash and then gave it away to needy families. He obtained a room for a poor old woman evicted from her tenement. He provided a bed for a dying invalid, and he supported 3 children of a sick and grieving widow. When friends asked him how he could stomach the stench of the slums, Pierre said, "It is to Jesus I go. Jesus comes to me every morning in Holy Communion, and I repay him in a very small way by visiting the poor. All around the sick and all around the poor, I see a special light which we don't have." Pier Giorgio often said, "Charity is not enough. In addition to charity, there must be social reform. Charity, yes, but also work for social justice." And so Pier took action to challenge the system that so neglected the poor. In 1919, he joined 2 social justice organizations that would later be suppressed by Mussolini's fascist government: the Catholic Student Federation and Catholic Action. Later, Pier Giorgio helped found a Catholic daily newspaper called Memento, devoted to spreading Catholic social teaching. For 7 years, he visited invalids in hospitals and at home, bringing medicine and food. In 1925, Pier was afflicted by an acute attack of polio, which doctors later speculated he caught from the poor and sick whom he tended. Neglecting his own health because his grandmother was dying, his illness was too advanced for anyone to treat when the doctors discovered how weak he was. Pier Giorgio Frassati died on July 4, 1925, at the age of 24, only 5 days after his polio was diagnosed. He kept a small ledger book containing detailed accounts of his transactions. While he lay on his deathbed, he gave instructions to his sister Luciana, asking her to see to the needs of the families who relied on his generosity. His last note, written with a nearly paralyzed hand, concerned a family who depended on him to pay for monthly medical injections. Only God knew of his good work. He himself never mentioned it to others. His family expected Turin's elite to come to offer their condolences and attend his funeral. They naturally expected to find many of his friends there as well. Imagine their surprise when they found the streets of the city lined with thousands of mourners as the cortege passed by. Those who mourned Pier Giorgio's death most were the poor and needy whom he had served so unselfishly for so many years. Many of these, in turn, were surprised to learn that the kind and generous young man they had come to know and appreciate came from such an influential family. At his beatification ceremony, Pope John Paul II called this pipe-smoking daredevil and prankster a man of the eight Beatitudes and a lover of God. Pier Giorgio Frassati was a vibrant young outdoorsman who combined a deep love for Christ, a desire to serve the needy, and a mission to make social and political life more just.